The PBU has made it very clear that it's not been a priority because they haven't put up enough funding to get it done. We will get it done because we believe it's a priority, and we will put the money in place to make sure it happens.
Michael Couture with Global National. Further to Kevin's point, are you just writing a blank check for all problems for all Indigenous communities across the country once you get into office?
So if Toronto had a drinking water problem, if Montreal had a drinking water problem, would you be asking the same question?
It's a lot of money, is what I'm saying. And people will look at it and go, how much money are we going to spend on all this? And how are you going to find that money?
That's a genuine question. Would you be asking this question if Vancouver did not have clean drinking water? Would you be asking this question if Edmonton did not have clean drinking water? No, you wouldn't. And that's what I'm saying. Why is it that we ask the question about whether or not Indigenous people should have clean drinking water? We got to take a minute and think, why is that even a question? Yes, they deserve clean drinking water. Yes, we can make it happen. It's a matter of priority, and I'm going to do it.
So if you watched my video yesterday, we talked about how Justin Trudeau is fighting Indigenous children in court who have suffered due to inadequate child services, and that this isn't the first instance of how Justin Trudeau has broke his many sacred promises to Indigenous people, whether it's on healthcare, or whether it's on housing, or whether it's on child services, or whether it's on education, or whether it's on clean drinking water. Justin Trudeau has lied to Indigenous people and has broken a promise to enact real reconciliation, real consultation, a real partnership between settler Canada and the Indigenous people of this land, the First Nations communities. And today, Jagmeet Singh was at Grassy Narrows, which is an Indigenous community that in many ways is the most emblematic of all that is wrong with Justin Trudeau and the Liberal Party. If Grassy Narrows sounds familiar to you, it's because it's the community that has been suffering from a long bout of mercury poisoning. Now, to be fair to Trudeau, this long predates him. This is a long-running issue, but Justin Trudeau promised real change and has not delivered. And the people of Grassy Narrows realize, they know this, that Justin Trudeau did not cause this problem, but has not done all that he can to actually solve it. And his government has failed to consult with the people there adequately. His Indigenous Affairs Minister has failed to do the work required to really meaningfully hear the concerns of the community. And on all these fronts, the people of that community have been deeply disappointed by Justin Trudeau. And this brings up one of Trudeau's ugliest moments of the last 4 years. And I say that without hyperbole, where a protester from the Grassy Narrows community went to one of his fundraisers and, you know, began to, protest his inaction at dealing with the fundamental, you know, human need for water access. And Justin Trudeau had the person removed and said in a sort of glib and you know, insulting manner, a mocking manner, thanks for your donation. And this corner, you know, the elites in the room all loved it. And it was so emblematic of Justin Trudeau's smarminess, his belief that, you know, he's doing the right thing and that all of these people, whether they're marginalized, whether they're Indigenous, if they protest him, it doesn't have any value and that, you know, he got their money. It doesn't matter. So he's saying to Indigenous people, you give me your money, you give me your votes. I don't need anything else from you. Thanks for your donation. And it was so epitomizing of Justin Trudeau's basic disregard for the human rights and dignity of Indigenous peoples that it sort of reignited a sense that he was not listening. And so as such, the chief of the community in Grassy Narrows, Rudy Turtle, is running for the NDP in this election. And he's running for the NDP because, like many Indigenous people, they were disappointed by the broken promises of Justin Trudeau, but have real faith in Jagmeet Singh. And so Jagmeet Singh was in Grassy Narrows today, and he made a strong commitment to fix the issues in that community, not just to clean the water there, but to clean the water in all Indigenous communities, and not just to remove the mercury poisoning from the water, not just to do that work, but to build a long-term commitment for treatment, which will take many, many, many years and cost, you know, dozens of millions of dollars. But the commitment needs to be made. And what was really troubling at this press conference today in Grassy Narrows, where Singh was there with Turtle, and he was also there with Sol Mamakwa, who's a Ontario NDP MPP in the Ontario legislature, was this narrative of Singh wanting to give a quote-unquote blank check to Indigenous people, to Indigenous communities, that, you know, the implication being Justin Trudeau and Andrew Scheer, I mean, I'm sure they want to do nice things, but they're being fiscally responsible. They don't want to give a blank check to the Indigenous people. They don't want to give blank checks to First Nations communities. So Singh, are you really willing to give a blank check? And that term was very much used, that disrespectful, you know, can we trust the Indigenous people not to waste the money kind of narrative? And Singh said, look, I'm making a commitment to justice. And I'm not like Justin Trudeau, and I'm not like previous Liberal and Conservative prime ministers who have used this language of fiscal responsibility to just slam Indigenous communities and ignore Indigenous communities and colonialize Indigenous communities and disrespect Indigenous communities. And he says, I'm making a commitment to justice. And he made one fantastic point, maybe above all, that if this was Toronto, or if this was Vancouver, or if this was any other settler city in Canada, especially large, wealthy cities with wealthy, you know, populations of European Canadians especially, we would solve the issue. We would solve the issue quickly, and we would not ask a question about the dollars needed. This is clean drinking water. We're not talking about building a sports arena. We're not talking about building a pipeline. We're not talking about corporate jets and corporate limousines. We're not talking about fancy new fridges for Galen Weston. We're talking about basic human needs here. And as such, the dollar cost is irrelevant. Canada is a rich enough society and an advanced enough society and a society that supposedly believes in human rights. So as such, the money's irrelevant. And so you can call it a blank check if you want and use the that connotation. But at the end of the day, this is a dedication to reconciliation, because reconciliation has a financial cost, especially when it comes to providing the basic services Indigenous people have been denied by Liberal and Conservative governments, including this one. And we saw it. We saw it yesterday. We see the Liberal government fighting tooth and nail to deny Indigenous people the money they are rightfully owed to compensate them for death and hardship and community destruction. And we see Andrew Scheer saying he would have done the exact same thing if he had the opportunity. And so Jagmeet Singh is saying quite the opposite, that we are making a dedicated commitment to social and economic justice in this country, and that doesn't exclude Indigenous people. That is for everybody, Indigenous and settler. Wherever you live in this country, we are going to ensure your basic human dignity is included. We cannot do any less than that. The time for, you know, using these narratives that are colonializing and that harm Indigenous people is over. And Jagmeet Singh has pointed that out today. Look, Justin Trudeau, you know, has tried to use Indigenous people as a virtue signal. And I hate using that term virtue signal because it's often used by the right. But Justin Trudeau is virtue signaling. He uses Indigenous people. He used them for their votes in 2015 when they placed their hope in them. And he used the concern that most Canadians have for Indigenous people. He weaponized that to win votes. And when the time came, a prime minister with absolute power in parliament and the population of people willing to support him and opposition parties like the NDP who would be willing to work with him in supporting him in helping these communities, Trudeau did nothing. He did nothing. And the Liberals will say, well, he did this and that and this and that, but it doesn't matter because Indigenous communities still to this day do not have clean drinking water. Indigenous communities to this day have not been compensated for acts of violent colonialism launched against them. Indigenous communities to this day still don't have equal access to healthcare. Indigenous communities to this day do not have equal access to education. And that is all in large part, in the largest part, thanks to this government's willful inaction. Look, Jagmeet Singh right now is the only leader who is even somewhat credible on the issue of delivering a platform of justice and equality for Indigenous people. And not just on this charitable style basis, like we are going to give to these people what they need, but rather we are going to fully commit to a long-range partnership between First Nations and between Canada to build a better society for everybody on this land. Indigenous people deserve nothing less, and settler Canadians who claim themselves to be allies to Indigenous people should expect nothing less from our government.